Let's say that you're out walking somewhere, and for some very strange reason, you haven't got a map and a compass with you, and you see your campsite off in the distance, and you want to know how far away it is, because you know you want to know how long it's going to take you to get there. So there is a way to do that, and it's called the rule of thumb. Now, a rule of thumb in English just means it's a saying that has been gained through experience and practice, rather than calculated. So it's virtually always correct, but not always. It'll give you an approximation. Now, as an example, I'll give you an example of a rule of thumb. Everybody knows that to cook a chicken, it's 45 minutes per kilo plus 20 minutes. Or using the imperial system, it will be 20 minutes per pound. Now, different sized chickens cook at different rates. So it's virtually always correct, but not always. So what we're going to do today is, let's say that that line of the forest behind me, that's my campsite, so I need to know how far away it is. Now, I look at the campsite, I'll face you so you can actually see what I'm going to do. All I'm going to do is I'm going to hold my thumb up, and I'm going to close one eye. And then I'm going to look at something on the line of the forest, and then I'm going to keep my arm still, and this time I'm going to look through my other eye. Okay, so I've now got 2 points. And then all you do is you estimate the distance between those 2 points. That's why it's a rule of thumb, because you have to estimate the distance. You estimate the distance and then add zero. So if you estimate the distance at 5 meters, then the distance from you to the target is 50 meters. If it's 10 feet, you add a zero and it's 100 feet. How simple is that? Let me go behind the camera, and then what I'll do is I'll use my thumb and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So here I am, I'm looking down the track at the edge of the forest, and I hold my thumb up, close one of my eyes, and it's covering where the track just enters the forest. Now I'm going to open my other eye, and now my thumb is just to the left of that tree that's standing out from the forest. Now, I'm not very good at judging distance, but I'm going to look down there. It's not quite 10 meters from where the track enters the forest to the left-hand side of this tree that's standing out on its own. It's not quite 10 meters, so it's about 8 or 9 meters. It's a guess. That's why this is a rule of thumb, because this is an approximation. You have to guess how far something is away. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to measure it, and then we'll see. Almost there. We're getting there slowly but surely. So, how far is it to those trees? Let's have a look. It is, hang on, here we go. So that was 50 meters, the first one. And I'm up to now, here we go. I don't know if you can see this, 36 meters. So it was actually, so that's 86 meters. So as I said, it works approximately. One way of doing it. So don't forget, hold your thumb up to something that you want to measure the distance from. Close one eye, then the other eye. Estimate the distance between the 2 points and then add a zero. So if it's 5 meters, then it'd be 50 meters. If it's 10 feet, then it'd be 100 feet. So all you do, add a zero, and that's the approximate distance from you to wherever you're looking at. Don't forget, this doesn't take into account dead ground. Dead ground is anything you can't see. So say you're on a hill and you're looking across at another hill, and there's a valley that you can't actually see all the way down and up the other side, that valley will be dead ground. But anyway, that's how to estimate distance using your thumb. What's that? Why did I do that at the end? I don't know. Thumbs up. Anyway, thanks for watching.